Nathaniel Bar-Jonah was a convicted pedophile and suspected serial killer and cannibal. He frequently impersonated police officers and attempted to lure children away from their homes. He was eventually arrested, but a judge ruled that the state had failed to prove that Bar-Jonah posed a public threat, so he was released, despite having told psychiatrists that he had a fascination of cannibalism. Not long after his release, a 10-year-old boy was reported missing. Witnesses claimed that they had seen him in an alleyway waiting for somebody. Another witness saw him being followed by an obese man matching Bar-Jonah's description, and the boy was distressed. The boy disappeared somewhere in the alleyway and was never seen again. When the police searched Bar-Jonah's apartment, they found a list of names. The list included the names of his previous victims, as well as the missing boy, followed by died. They also found newspaper clippings regarding the case all over his apartment. A former flatmate of Bar-Jonah's reportedly found clothes in his apartment, which matched the ones the missing boy was wearing on the day he went missing. A notebook was also discovered with coded writing. It took months for the police and FBI to crack the code, but eventually managed. Bar-Jonah had written in-depth descriptions of cannibalism, as well as cooking recipes involving the body parts of children. The recipe titles included Little Boy Pot Pie and Roasted Child. Despite weighing over 300 pounds and known to have a large appetite, police found that he had not made any significant food purchases for almost a month after the missing boy's disappearance. During this time, he frequently held barbecues for his neighbors, who mentioned frequently that the meat he was serving tasted strange. Police later found a meat grinder in his apartment, which contained human DNA. The police were never able to connect Bar-Jonah to the missing boy, and they never found the identity of the DNA from the meat grinder. The authorities in Montana, where the kidnapping occurred, weren't aware of his previous convictions, which took place in Massachusetts. He had divulged some of his crimes to his probation officer, so the probation officer made a request to have his records sent through, but the records were never actually sent. He had shown cannibalistic tendencies from the age of 6. Teachers would frequently call his mother to notify that Bar-Jonah was upsetting staff and students by eating all of his scabs and sucking his own blood. Whilst in prison, guards also observed this, as well as reporting that he appeared to be achieving sexual pleasure from it. It's probably worth mentioning that Bar-Jonah began his attempted killing spree when he was just 7. He lured a 5-year-old girl into his basement, attempted to strangle her, but was stopped by the girl's mother when she heard the screams. When he was 13, he tried the same thing with a 6-year-old boy, sexually assaulting him. He tried it once again a few years later with 2 boys, intending to kill them, but the boys wouldn't follow. His next documented assault was attempted murder, occurred when he was 18, and was believed to be the first time he impersonated a law official in order to assault a child. The child was found in the car with Bar-Jonah, covered in blood and his own excrement, nearly dead. He impersonated law officials several times in his life and was eventually, at age 20, arrested and charged with attempted murder, receiving the maximum sentence. During this time in prison, he changed his name from David Paul Brown to Nathaniel Benjamin Levy Bar-Jonah, so that he could understand what it was like to be subjected to anti-Semitism. He acknowledged this in an interview with Dr. Michael Stone for Most Evil. It was in this year that the judge ruled the state had not provided enough evidence to prove that Bar-Jonah was still dangerous, leading to his release. A month after his release from prison, age 34, and already morbidly obese, Bar-Jonah saw a 7-year-old boy sitting in a car alone. He entered the car and sat on the boy until witnesses and the boy's mother saw what was happening and ran over, prompting Bar-Jonah to flee the car. A police officer recognized the witness's description as Bar-Jonah and arrested him. Bar-Jonah first claimed that he had been attempting to get out of the rain, but later admitted that he had been trying to kill the boy. He was sentenced to probation. Police made the arrest when Bar-Jonah was found near a school, dressed as a law official and carrying a stun gun and pepper spray. Bar-Jonah was supposed to be tried for the murder and cannibalism of Zach Ramsey, but the child's mother would not cooperate with the police, believing that her son was still alive. It is believed that Bar-Jonah may have first attempted to run the boy over in his car, as witnesses described seeing a white car come close to hitting the boy. It was later confirmed that Bar-Jonah had access to his mother's car, which matched the description of the vehicle. At around the same time as the boy's disappearance, Bar-Jonah had been seen standing by a dumpster wearing a police uniform, matching the pattern of a police impersonation from his previous kidnappings in the same alleyway. While conducting the investigations into Zach Ramsey's disappearance, the detectives also found the word Tita in Bar-Jonah's garage. This is assumed to have been a misspelling of Teta, the surname of another boy who had been kidnapped 13 years prior. Bar-Jonah would have been 16. The boy had later been found dead, having been strangled and sexually assaulted. Huge lists of names were found written down. It is suggested that this may have been a list of his victims. After all of this, Bar-Jonah was eventually arrested for impersonation of a law official. However, after detectives found pictures of children and a bone belonging to a boy, he was charged with kidnapping and sexual assault. He was also charged with torture. Many of his crimes occurred after the state of limitations had expired.